Woman, what say you?
Olmec, you have come to us. Thank the gods, for our prayers have been answered.
Yes, your prayers reach me, and I am here. What is your station?
I am the wife of the chieftain.
Why was your husband spared Quetzalcoatl's wrath?
He was praying inside the temple of the Jaguar when the evil one came. By the time the echoes of death reached him, the battle was over. He emerged to find nearly the entire village destroyed. He was bound by tradition to become chieftain. Thus he cannot attack Quetzalcoatl. And now he broods in a dark mood. He sees himself a coward for not being able to die in battle with the others.
What happened during the battle?
At first, when we saw our revered king back from the land of the dead, we were overjoyed. We thought he had come back to lead us to great victories. Instead, he came to destroy us. Although our warriors fought fiercely, Quetzalcoatl scattered them like broken twigs. After they had been killed, he unleashed his dark magic on us.
What magics did he wield?
He caused a massive wave to come down and crush the Temple of Water. He caused the earth to shake violently. The mountain broke apart and almost crushed all the huts, burying the Temple of Wind. Only the Temple of the Jaguar withstood his power.
You speak of tradition as though it is undesirable. Your husband should be honored to be chieftain.
But Olmec, oh wise one, it was never his desire to become chieftain, especially not this way. Working with the earth and revealing the secrets it hid inside brought him great joy.
Who remains in the village?
There are but a handful of us left. My husband does what he can to repair the damage of the walls of the huts, but his mind, it's elsewhere. The death of our beloved daughter weighs heavily upon him.
She was killed in the battle?
My husband insists that she was crushed beneath the boulders which destroyed the village walls.
You speak as though you disbelieve your own words.
I cannot help myself. I somehow feel that she still lives.
This lowly worker appears strong and proud. You there, what is your station?
I was the stonemason. Now I am village chief. What are you, and why do you enter this village?
I am Olmec, holy warrior. You dare address me in that tone?
I do. You may frighten the others, but you'll get no such satisfaction from me. Where were you when we needed you most? Your arrival now means nothing to me. You're too late.
You say I am late, but you are wrong.
Is that so? My precious daughter lies crushed beneath these rocks. The day Quetzalcoatl arrived, I prayed to your god with all my heart. And you come to us now? The warriors are dead. The temples are in ruins. My daughter is dead.
You say your daughter is dead. How do you know?
She was in her hut when the rocks fell. Look around you. Death is everywhere. I have lost everything that is dear to me.
You say you were the stonemason?
Yes, that is my trade. Like my father before me and his father before him, I work the earth, shaping it to my will. I am a simple craftsman who now rules what's left of this village, a heavy burden on my weary shoulders.
There are worse fates, Mason.
I know. I have seen what happens to those who oppose Quetzalcoatl's rule.
His punishment is swift and severe, in death as it was in life, when he ruled this village as king.
Yes, but he was just and true back then, not this abomination which has returned to destroy us. We revered him when he was of flesh and bone, and upon his death, we crafted a tomb as a monument to his greatness. I myself crafted the stones and jewelry he was adorned with.
Mason, I would have a word with you. I have spoken with the spirit of Tepetuk, warrior and husband to Kalkihut.
The fisherman? His spirit remains here?
Yes. You have the necklace that belongs to his wife. Give it to her, or I will shatter your limbs like twigs.
Very well. Tell your spirit I will deliver his gift.
An empty copper bowl. It must have been used for sacrifices. A truly venerable woman. Old woman, what say you?
I see the Oracle was successful in summoning you. Although at this point, I don't see much use in it. The damage has been done. You have no purpose here.
What do you mean by that, bitter crone? I am Olmec. I fight for the gods themselves.
You sound as zealous as my husband, the fool.
What man would be mad enough to wed your sour tongue, old one?
Tezcatl, the witch, is my husband. He fathered two fine warriors with me, and now he runs to meet death's embrace. Meanwhile, I must sit obediently while he throws away his life on a fool's errand.
What errand do you speak of?
He plans on fighting that bastard. Undead king using his small magic. He is doomed and will die in vain.
Where are your two sons? Did they die in battle?
Yes. Quetzalcoatl shattered their bodies as though they were made of straw. Soon my fool husband will join them, and I'll be truly alone.
What is that you are mixing?
Nothing important, holy one. Just a simple balm for my aching bones. Age has not been kind to me.
I have spoken with the Mason Dead One. He will deliver the gift as promised.
Honorable Olmec, truce in your rest. I am grateful. Temple awaits you.
There. The way is open to me. The Unholy One's power must be great indeed. The Temple of Wind. Boulders are no match for the mighty Olmec. Ugh. Stonemason's daughter. Your parents miss you greatly. I will take you home.
Kotlkyu, my daughter, you have returned from death.
Fool! She was trapped within the temple. Had you not been so stubborn and full of self-pity, you would have realized that.
Oh, my precious daughter! I'm so sorry. Go see your mother. She misses you terribly.
I have found your daughter, woman.
Oh, thank you, Olmec. You have brought hope back into the lives of myself and my husband. As long as we have hope, the future will remain as bright as the sun.
The jewelry suits you well, widow.
Thank you, Olmec. You have brought much happiness to my sad heart. Every time I see its reflection in the waters, I will think of my husband, and of you, for granting me this inner peace.
Ah, a precious little one. The path is Child, why were you in the temple?
The shiny rock. It's pretty, and I like the music, too.
Shiny rock?
Yes, it's a big crystal, like the ones Father makes into jewelry. He made a scary mask before, and a necklace, and a lot of rings.
What music do you speak of, little one?
The gongs. Sometimes I can get a few of them to make the same sound. It's fun!
These gongs produce music. A large crystal. I can see something inside. Totem. There is the evil god himself. Quetzalcoatl, why have you returned to this place?
Olmec, I should have known you'd come. You follow your god's commands like the dog that you are. Go back down to your followers and wait for your death as they do. You are powerless against me here.
You dare speak to me in such a tone? I have enough power to handle the likes of you.
Empty threats from a cowardly warrior.
Why do you seek to destroy those that worshipped you? You were their greatest king.
Ah, they are loyal to none but themselves. Soon after my death, they stopped offering sacrifice, and now they will pay with their lives.
Why have you left your heavenly throne? For a god to return to this land is a disgrace.
I am more than a god. I am a warrior. That idle throne is an empty chair that threatens to devour my eternal soul. I will conquer this world one village at a time until all are destroyed.
And then what? When there is nothing left to conquer, what will you do?
I grow with the power of the souls I consume. When this world has been stripped of all its souls, I will be the most powerful god of all! I will conquer the heavens!
A large statue. Violent earth magic has made it unstable. What does this noble warrior seek?